This is the only digital research channel in India producing the documentary ethnographic films on the endangered human populations and ethnic cultures of India. So subscribe this channel to know more about the endangered human population and ethnic cultures of India on every weekend. Bichia and Asur are the important population living on the Vindhya Parvat region in the central India of India. They are the people who has given us iron for the human civilization. Now these people are facing survival problem. They are under the verge of extinction. Several months were spent to document the film in the Jharkhand state itself. This film may emerge as an historical research document for the future generation to know about the Bijia tribe. It is unfortunate we are not able to protect and save these two aborigines who has given iron civilization to the mankind. Please watch this movie and decide what way we can help to save these aboriginal population.
Bijia is one of the ancient ethnic group inhabiting in the state of Jharkhand. They are inhabiting from Raigada towards east of Netherhat. The place is an inaccessible area. From Ranchi it takes entire day. The road which leads to the Netherhat, it is very steep hills with rich flora and fauna. The roads are very narrow. The Netherhat region plateau region, the hot place for the Naxalites. I have spent several days to find out the ways to reach the Bijia settlements to document the film. With great difficulty, I convinced the local people to work among the Bijias. They have given me permission to work from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. in the villages. All the villages of Bijia are under the coverage of Naxalites. So in this document, I am not able to do 100% justice. But however, I done my level best keeping life under risk. The Bijia consists of three sub-tribal groups, once having the same substance of economy, such as bir, that is coal, Bijia and Agaria Asurs. The Asurs and Bijia are classified as primitive tribes in Indian constitution. The word Asur is referred in the sacred text of Hindus, such as Rigveda, Upanishads and in the epics Mahabharata and Ramayana. These are the ancient people with rich cultural heritage who has given the iron civilization to the human society. The present iron stupa which you are seeing here is placed at Qutub place near Qutub Minar in Delhi, is the gift given by the Bijias and Asurs. Roads leading to Bijia settlements are very narrow and also risk to travel in these roads.
वो लोग असुर कहाँ कौन सा हिल्स में है, बिरजिया कौन सा जगह में है, सेपरेट जगह में?
ये तो हम लोग बिरजिया जनजाति के प्रचुर अधिकतर मात्रा में ये पूर्वी पठार जो बिशुनपुर के पूर्व क्षेत्र के जो पहाड़ी है उसमें है, और पश्चिमी पठार जो नेत्रहाट के तरह पहाड़ी पर है उसको हम लोग पश्चिमी पठार कहते हैं, उधर असुर जनजाति के लोग अधिक
पश्चिमी में।
हाँ पश्चिमी में,
और पूर्वी में जितने भी लोग हैं सारे
बिरजिया
जनजाति,
छिटपुट असुर भी है लेकिन अधिकतर प्रचुर मात्रा में बिरजिया
बिरजिया।
और शुरू के दिनों में तो लोग सड़क।
इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ मैन इन सर्च ऑफ मैन सीरीज प्रेजेंटली आई एम ऑन द विंध्य पर्वत which is in Chota Nagpur Plateau region, which you can see this Vindhya Parvat. All these are the Vindhya hills which surrounded me, which is rich in hematite and bauxite iron ore. These are the area where the multinational companies are exploiting the iron ore. Mishanpur, we took a taxi and then we were transferred to the truck. From there, we have started walking. It is almost It took more than 6-7.5 hours for us to reach. You can see here, it is now 12:30. We have started at 6 o'clock. Almost 6.5 hours it took for us to come to this village of Bhirjia, where we are now going to document the film. Now let us go into the Bhirjia village. Let us see the way of life in these remote jungles.
The census figures from 1961 to 2011 shows there is a small growth in the population figures. My observation and field work shows that the total population of Bhirjia may not be more than 3000 individuals, and this population living in the five villages in the core area of Vindhya Parvat region.
Liquid item. Morphologically, the Bhirjia looks to be different from the local tribes of Munda and Warom. You can observe here the color, complexion and the physical characteristics varies from the local tribes.
Here the prognathism is, we can find the prognathism, and the lips, lower lip is bigger, and the nose is very broad and long also. One important characteristic, morphological characteristic observed is the ear eyebrows here. The eyebrows and eye distance is very small, you can see here, compared to other populations. That is what, and the forehead is also, you can see here, this is, you can observe this circumference. If you observe, it is prolonged, question is here. That is one of the important one. Here also you can see the face, forehead among the ladies. The lip is big. And the nose is broad, and the root of the nose is depressed, and the eyes, you know, which you can observe here, is a small, like mongoloid features we can observe among this population. And earlobe attachments is a unique population, and we can see the color of this population is also unique.
The dress pattern of both men and women are very simple. Women wear a sari and a blouse, men will wear a pant or a shirt. Many of the times they will be wearing a dhoti, which is 2 meters width and 1.5 meter height. The women and men, both of them are facing a problem of the clothing. Most of them are not having the extra clothing to change their clothing when they are taking bath also. This is a pathetic condition among the Bhirjia. These are the hills which are rich in bauxite. The village itself is situated on the bauxite mines. See, I was told by the local tribals, those who are inhabiting in this region, that they are living on the hollow shell. That means, you know, the entire bauxite beneath their village was taken away by the multinational companies. Because of that reason, that is why they are not able to get the water. The water which they used to get from the wells also dried because of they have excavated the bauxite beneath their villages.
the villages are placed on the top of the shell. That means, you know, if you dig 10 meters depth, there will be a hollow. That is what these people are telling. All these lands are agricultural lands. If you dig for about 3 feet, you will get the bauxite. So many of the tribes, they have sold the lands for the mining purposes and got the money and migrate to different places. That is the pathetic condition which you can observe in this region. The Birjia villages are characterized by isolated homesteads, fenced within enclosures, scattered at random, implying individualistic housing pattern. Houses in the Birjia villages lie in scattered. Birjia houses are rectangular in size, having mud walls and floor. The tiled sloping roofs are supported by center and side poles. Each house had a long veranda and a short veranda in front, separated by the main door entrance. The verandas are used for sleeping by grown-up children at night and grinding and husking purposes in daytime. The houses are divided into three parts, that is kitchen, living and store, which are often separated by wattle partitions. The hearth is built around one corner below an overhanging wattle container to keep the provisions and dry grains during monsoon. Women deeply involved in plastering and painting of the walls, which you can see here. These are the walls with made the bamboo. On it, with cow dung and red soil, she has plastered first. Then second one, with indigenous black color, with charcoal she has prepared and applying on this second coating, which you observe here. Indigenous colors she is using on the as the second coating, which she is mixing the colors. You can see here. Is really, they will take a lot of interest, the women decorating their houses before festival days, that is especially on Holi. And most of the time they will be spending for this purpose, the leisure times, painting on the walls and making. Now, the final coating, she is making the painting with white color, which is indigenously collected by herself and made the calcium. And she is applying, you can see the design. She is making in such a way, the beautiful designs it is coming. Really it is amazing to see how they are making the houses. She is mixing up the colors and combinations. It is really an interesting subject for any human being. In every house, we will find the husking indigenous equipment, which is called as jockey. This equipment which you are observing here will be used for husking paddy. That means they will prepare rice with this, and also they will prepare rice powder and also pulses, breaking, all these things, you know, they will be using this jockey for making. So it is an indigenous method still they are following for their rice making. In majority of the houses, Birjia used to brew their own mahua liquor. Here you can observe, in one of the houses we have observed the mahua liquor preparation. It consists of three parts: down mahua liquor with jaggery, and the second one, the pot where they can able to collect the vapors, and third one, the cold water where they will be burning in beneath the mahua flowers and liquor, and the liquor will be coming into this tube into the bottle. Then they will collect it and they will use to have their own mahua liquor. So sometimes they used to sell this mahua liquor also to the outsiders or to the own people. We can see here indigenous way of preservation of the mahua liquor. These are the pumpkin containers which is made. In this they will store the mohol liquor for their future consumption. Jowar, rice, ragi and millets constitute the staple food for Birjia, supplemented by vegetables, fish, meat, a variety of seasonal fruits, roots and tubers collected from the jungle, few simple items from boiled rice, ragi and millets, and their gruels are prepared and regularly eaten. Spices like tamarind, chili, salt, turmeric are also used for making vegetarian and non-vegetarian dishes.
Askal means?
This is one of the tuber collected from the forest, which you can observe here. This one, they will cut into pieces and they will boil with the salt and they will eat this tuber as a main food. Certain times, they will dry it for some time and preserve it, and during summer period they will be eating. Here we can observe the green leaves collected from the forest. These leaves they will make the curry. For future they will dry it and preserve it in the mud pot, and they will make it a curry during summer seasons when the food is not available. This is the way of life for their substance of economy and for their livelihood. Family plays an important role in social and economic organization of the Birjia community. Father is the head of the family. This descent is patrilineal or agnatic descent. Inheritance of the property is also through male line. The role of residence is patrilocal. Traditionally, joint families were common, but nowadays the nuclear families are predominant among the Birjia. Monogamy is a rule, but polygyny is also observed occasionally. So one can notice polygynous families along with the monogamous families in Birjia community. Birjia have both affinal and consanguinal relationships. Kinship relations among the Birjia are broad-based, cognates are traced in male line and referred to as agnates. The Birjia maintain cordial relations with their kins and use specific terms to refer the relationship between the individuals and address them accordingly. There are differences between the addressing of people younger and elder to the persons involved. The Birjia have extensive kinship networks. They have kins in more than 5 villages where they are inhabiting. The kinship relations between villages are established through affinal relations, that is marriage links. Marriage plays a very important role in kinship networks of Birjia. The social organization of Birjia society is divided into two exogamous clans, which are totemic in nature. They are Senduria and Telia. These two groups are plays an important role in marriage, alliances and establishing kinship bondages. In this village, we have Senduria and Telia, two gotras which are exogamous in nature. Marrying within the clan is strictly prohibited. One has to marry outside the clan. That is the rule and the tradition of the Birjia society. The Birjia follow strict endogamy at community level. One do not marry outside the community. The breach of marrying outside, which is considered the breach of law. The sanctions may range from excommunication from tribe or from village. The preferential method of acquiring a mate among the Birjia is by negotiation, which involves long procedure depending upon the talks of the either party. The boy's parents put forward the proposal and start negotiations. After the successful negotiation, marriage is usually performed at the house of the bridegroom. The other methods of acquiring a mate among the ब्रिजिया और मैरिज बाय कैप्चर, मैरिज बाय म्यूचुअल लव, मैरिज बाय एलोपमेंट, मैरिज बाय एक्सचेंज एंड मैरिज बाय पिया, विच इज अ यूनिक फॉर्म ऑफ मैरिज विच विल बी परफॉर्म्ड ओनली अमंग द ब्रिजिया कम्युनिटी. Bia is a unique form of marriage exist among the Brijia community. This is a form of marriage where the boy and the girl likes to live together. They will establish a family, live separately. They will have the sex and also produce the children without marriage. So this is mainly due to the poverty and the payment of the bride price. When they will have the money procurement, then they will go for the marriage. They will produce the children and it is also legally recognized in their community. We also have the custom of marriage by intrusion. In this case, the girl enters forcibly into the family of the beloved and stays there with that boy house. If the boy is willing to accept her, he can do so, but he does not pay bride price in that case. Generally, this type of marriages, marriage by intrusion, marriage by elopement, marriage by capture, all these forms of marriages is performed because they are not able to pay the bride price, which is expensive. Certain cases they had to pay the bride price 30 parts of liquor. That is the heavy amount, and they have to pay kind also and cash also, that is goat, sheep, cow, and also the money up to 200 to 600 rupees. That is why they prefer to go for this type of marriages. Let us find out from her how much bride price she has got during her marriage. When I questioned, she told that she has got 40 pots of rice beer as a bride price, and also goat, one cow, she has got as a bride price. That is the important one, which is very expensive, and also they have to give the feast. That is why most of them are avoiding arranged marriages among the Brijia. Divorce is freely allowed among the Brijia society. Both men and women can divorce. If a woman proposes the divorce, then she has to pay back the bride price which has been paid by her husband. That is the rule. They can marry again whom they like. There is no restriction among these people again remarriage. Widow remarriage is allowed. Liberate and sororate marriages are also allowed. The status of women comparatively other communities is very high, and women have the liberty to choose her mate.
So the menstrual period stops, then they will identify she is pregnant. Then Darvi, what is the name
Dagreen,
of the green? The green is the maid. She will be assisting for the deliveries.
Is the same community, belongs same community.
Same community. And she will be she will be confirming that she is a pregnant. And she will be taking care of all the 9 months by Dagreen for the deliveries. So
acha tab ka ka kar ho Dagreen ka ka kar hai
kuch nahi hani pita hai daru pita hai kya karenge ego jeete re chhua na hum to chakhna tak mar deta hai ki khayenge hum.
She will be giving different kinds of medicines.
Tu karwaba hi na log ke
aap hai Dagreen, aap Dagreen hai
ha.
Oh, she is Dagreen. She is conducts the deliveries. And aap kaisa karta hai deliveries?
Kaise kya kal ke tab ye thi murgha batha upar jayenge hum aage bache hum dikhenge.
No, bachcha aisa ho jayega, kaisa karega aap?
Hum unhe ke hum जन्म करेंगे.
वो जन्म करवाती है कि उसका कैसे मैंने मुंडी जो है सो
उसका
जो है
सीधा
तो
सीधा कैसा लेगा
सीधा करेंगे हम सीधा करेंगे
वो बाय द ट्रेडिशनल नॉलेज सर
बच्चा निकल गया
सर
ठीक है. द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द डिलीवरी हाउ इट इज यस करो
हाथ वो बच्चा आवे ना गा है करेगा करी बताए ना
दर्द के कारण तू
हाँ आगे बैठा मुझे
सब बच्चा इधर उधर जाएगा ना इधर हो जाए ऐसे कैसे करेगी
हाँ ऐसा करेगी हाँ
So this side you come under, sir. Then she will be making that head and other things straight. And how she will be, she is demonstrating how she will make this straight and how she will be taking the baby out. It's very important, even still is among these.
Here,
here,
here. Okay, cut it. Ati suta se band ka.
एगो पहले तो पत्ती नहीं हलो
छुरी रही थी के काटल लो
आजकल ना कान करना कुछ करता है क्या फंक्शन
नहीं आपको
नहीं नहीं, नहीं 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 आपका कौन 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 ये किया
ये तो हम पीछे हम थे दही
कौन किया आपको
कोई नहीं अपन से
आपको
अपन से
हाँ अपन
नहीं 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 वो तो बाजार में कोई कह रहा है
बाजार में सोना मान के कीन लेते हमार से ये कीन के लगाई ही हो
नहीं नहीं वो छेद के कह रहा
हूँ
सोनार
सोनार करता
अच्छा सोनार
मैं नियर उग्रा में का कोई
नो स्पेसिफिक राइट्स सेरेमनीज एंड टैबूस आर एसोसिएटेड विद इनिशिएशन एंड प्यूबर्टी एट दिस टाइम द बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स enjoy unfettered freedom of premarital love and romance among themselves before they finally choose their life companion to be tied in a wedlock and be called as Bia. The young boys and girls till the age of marriage, they used to spend their time in Dumkuriya, that is, you know, we call as youth organizations, where they will learn dance, songs and music, folk songs, folklore. This Dumkuriya also works as an economic organization where they will work for the entire community during the seedling, harvesting and construction of the houses and other communal festivals. They will unite together and work for the entire community. So he is also one of the youth dormitories which is still existing in the Birjia society. Slowly, the youth dormitories are decreasing because of the migration of many of the youth to the urban places for their livelihood. The death is called as Bogane. So, the dead body will be disposed on the same day or the next day. But all the dead bodies, they will be burying. No question of cremation. Only in the case of measles, snake bite and accidents only they will be cremating. Generally, it is performed on the same day of the death.
ऐसा करके एकदम पथल दे दी
मट्टी
ऑन द 10th डे ऑफ द डेथ दे विल परफॉर्म ए प्यूरिफिकेटरी सेरेमनी व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज कॉमी दिस सेरेमनी इज परफॉर्म्ड टू वार्ड ऑफ ऑल ईविल स्पिरिट्स व्हिच हैज बीन कॉज्ड ड्यूरिंग हिज टाइम ऑफ लिवलीहुड दिस इज परफॉर्म्ड विथ ऑल द किन्समैन एंड ऑल्सो द विलेजर्स On this day, they will be worshipping the dead ancestors also by placing some stones. This is a very important function which will be performed among these people. On this day, they will be giving vegetarian food feast and also the liquor to all the people.
Chawal dal.
Chawal dal.
Traditional substance of economy once was the iron smelting for the Birjias. They lost the traditional substance of economy and they depend on the forest for food gathering, hunting, fishing and shifting cultivation. Due to the forest policies implemented by the government of India and the multinational companies enter into the territories of Birjia for mining the iron ore, they lost their lands and now they are under the threat. These are the agricultural lands. Presently they are doing the agriculture. The crops cultivated in these lands are maize, jowar, red gram, millets, black gram, and some of the vegetables they will be growing for their consumption are brinjal, millet, Niger. They also grow ragi and so on. These are some of the crops they will be producing in these agricultural fields, and almost all the crops are depending on the rain. Even today, for the subsistence, they are depending on the forest. This is the fiber they will be collecting from the plants, and they will be making the ropes and baskets with this one. They also collect the firewood for as a fuel, and it will be sold to the local business people for money. From the forest, we will be collecting jackfruits, mango, kendu, dimri, oranges, tangani, siali, kabri, tall, tamarind, roots and tubers of different kind, leaves known as khortla, dhulia, dundibeda, bajji, gudiyali are some of the items we are collecting from the forest. Mahua flowers are also collected for brewing liquor. Sex-wise division of labor is conspicuously marked among the Birjia regarding carrying out their regular subsistence activities. Men shoulder the harder responsibilities like cutting down trees, tilling land, constructing and thatching the house, hunting and food preparation in communal feasts which are tabooed for women. Women, apart from their cooking, cleaning utensils, sweeping, bringing water from the streams and wells are the major work, and the household activities cooperate with men to work in the fields, clearing, shifting cultivation sites, weeding, fencing, reaping and thrashing corns, harvesting, preserving grain and food materials, rearing animals, collection of food and forest products, fishing, basket making, in all possible ways among the Birjia. Coordination of efforts and collective endeavor through mutual help and cooperation show significant characteristics of their social life.
But in a traditional political system, all people will sit together and they will decide.
With women also.
With women also they will sit together, men and women sit together, they will dispose the cases. They doesn't have a specific panchayat system and village traditional leaders. So all sit together, they will sort out the cases and dispute. They will dispose the cases.
Penalty.
They dispose the cases with penalty. That is, you know, fining. That fine will be spent for the liquor and also for eating for that day among all the community people.
It's a simple over here.
Sarna Besna. Okra mein koon devta rahula?
Baiga puja jani.
Baiga puja.
Baiga.
Baiga puja seva kare.
Baiga. Ke tohniye ke jat karo.
Na.
Baiga.
Jeta sab.
Five villages in this region. So annual festivals will be performed joining together all the five villages. So it is jointly they will be doing this performance, and for the priest they will be selecting entire all the five villages, they will be selecting a priest to perform that puja. That name of that priest is called as Baiga. Baiga will be performing the puja for 1 year. Again, next year they will be selecting another black magic here, and they will be, whenever they require, they will be going to the Devhari for the treatment also to eradicate the, some of the ailments which they are having.
They believe in ghost.
They are ghost. They believe in
if,
the ghost.
If spirits. Any ghost will come in head or any body, so Devhari will remove.
So they have the belief that the ghost will be coming on them. So whenever they feel that the ghost is there from the head or on the body, so they will go to the Dehari and he will treat them that by performing a certain rituals.
The ghost will be removed.
they have the faith in the power and ecstasy of several deities. Sigi Devata, Mahadevi Parvati, Dharga, Mara Jevata, Indra Bhagavan, Agni, Snake, etc. are the deities of the Birjiya. Also, the ancestor spirit is being worshipped. Several is the religious festival and is treated in a great vivacity. They also worship some symbolic representatives.
Which will sing on the religious occasions for worshipping of these people.
Yes.
सर्वदा देवी देवता हम खड़ा रहना चाहिए आपको लिखतर है भैया कौन है हमारा प्रणाम भैया भगवान है भगवान भगवान यहाँ कोई हमारे आदमी हमारा नहीं है भगवान है भगवान के तो पूजा कर रहे हम है भैया चलिए भाई हम के इतना हम पाठ पूजा करने के हम है अच्छा ठीक है आसमान है आसमान आसमान है कौन है दीदी का अंकर है अंकर है हम है भगवान है भगवान भगवान है देवी देवता भगवान है ईसा ना के कोई कोई संकट नहीं है हम है भाग सकता है कुछ नहीं कुछ भगवान है भगवान भगवान पूजा करने हम ले आए ठीक है चलिए क्या करोगे अपन घर का दूर के शक्ति करना चाहिए हम है
अच्छा ठीक है और
देवता माने भगवा करके का बात हो
अच्छा
होली
होली कर हाँ फगुआ भी तारे जाना प्रीति दुनिया देवता माने तब गए कित गए इधर
पापुली गथा लरे सरो बाली देने उमर गले उरी चपा फूल गथा मारे सारो पारिले देने मारे कले ओरिया चलू देवा आओ तो मारा कुता पालियों दे भोगे
आयो
पूजा करु देवान पारी के हुए भाया आओ तो गा देवान पूजा करुगे देवान आओ तो मुलाकात भैया रो रे कुमारी पूजा करु रे देवान घरा तोरा घरा तोरा सुना बे ले गे नायू घरा तोरा घरा तोरा सुना बे
उस समय में कुछ गाना गाता है
ना रोएंगे रोएंगे
रोएंगे कैसा रोएंगे रो कर दिखा रो कर दिखा ना कैसा रोता है गाना गाकर रोता है ना
रोने के लिए थी
इधर का है ना ये रे आया बाबा गे
इसे डेथ सॉन्ग है दे विल बी सिंगिंग दिस सॉन्ग
और काटे ऐसे ना इसे करके कहिए
अच्छा
हरे बाबा जो अमा तो अम से नो जाना ओ का पढ़ाई से ना अमा गे आयो गे जो पढ़ो ना गे आया गे अगुता मिंगे ए करनी से निया इन्हा दो ने दे दमा धुड़ के देना चौकी रे गंडो रे मैं धुड़ के दिंगे आया गे
अच्छा है। मंदार मंदार
मंदार
मंदार बोलो
मंदार
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 मंदार बोलो बजाओ
यो तुरे जले ना जडे उदा कनै रे पकाले ना बका बंदा हकुदा रे समय समय ना पतिया बे कनै समान देखिया वाले
They have started. This is the steel plate which will be used for eating. This is a cup. With this he is using a. Iska naam kya bolta hai ab?
Isko. Chipni.
Yes ko.
Judge.
Judge. This is called as judge.
Judge. Aapko bhi.
Bajao.
Haan.
Judge. Bata. Bajao.
Judge
aayi. Haan. Judge aayi. Judge. Bata. Bajao.
Girao
yaar. Isse girao. Nahi. Aap bhi bajao.
The expansion of human civilization, establishment of the industries and transportation and communication has directly affected the peaceful way of life of the tribes inhabiting in the hill regions. The first and second 5-year plan period, the government of India established the iron and steel industries and also the private companies like Tata's and Birla's, they have started their steel industries at Jamshedpur, Rourkela and Bokaro. These steel industries directly affected the livelihoods of the Jharkhand and Bihar tribes. The extraction of the iron ore in the tribal habitation started and slowly it has fallen into the hands of the multinational companies that made life of the tribes miserable. the traditional occupation of Birjia was directly affected. Many of the tribes lost their livelihood and the substance of economy. They are forced to change their substance economy from iron melting, making the iron implements to the daily wage laborers. These are the lands which you are observing here. This is the Vindhya Parvat, which is rich resources of wax and hematite. The multinational companies has entered into these territories and dug away the bauxite minerals as though they are inhabiting here, but there is nothing is available inside their village. That is the pathetic conditions which they are living presently. Many of the tribal lands were taken away by the multinational companies by paying a meager amount for extracting the iron ore. These are the lands which you are observing here. It became barren and no water resources are available because of the mining in these regions. Now they lost their drinking water also. They had to go miles together to fetch the water. This is, you can see here, the Vindhya Parvat completely is rich in iron ore. There are a lot of companies. Every day hundreds of trucks are coming in this region and taking the iron ore. Water is the one of the major problem which they are facing. They had to go miles together to fetch the water, which you can observe here. She is taken a tin with that container. They are bringing the water. At least 4 kilometers they have to go for bringing the water for drinking. Many of them are not taking bath. Once in a month only they are taking bath. Is the pathetic condition presently they are living. Due to the interference of outside, non-tribal and forest problems and programs, the Birjia are being exploited, alienated and lost control over the environment and thereby struggling to survive. The loss of forest is posing a great problem, especially for women who take their responsibility to feed themselves and their family. The Birjia are struggling for their survival. Several of them lost their lands and houses because they are not having the patta for their lands. Pressure on the land has increased, so they are forced to shift their houses to the peripheries of the hill region. None of them possess a patta land and a patta for their houses. Malnutrition is quite common among these people. Maternal mortality and infant mortality rate is also very high. This is mainly due to the neglect of healthcare practices. Most of them are anemic. From the inception of the pregnancy to its termination, no specific nutritional diet was consumed by women. The consumption of iron, calcium, vitamins during pregnancy is very poor. The habit of consumption of liquor during pregnancy was found to be common among the women. Due to the restrictions by the forest department in food gathering and hunting in the forest, they are forced to change their food habit to eat the rice. They are now slowly depending on the rice provided by the public distribution system. The rice they are getting is not sufficient for their consumption. Due to lack of education and requisite skills, the Birjia are not able to take advantage of the new economic opportunities which has been grabbed by the plain people migrated to the tribal areas where Birjia are concentrated. The schools are far away distance. One has to go for elementary school for about 3 to 4 kilometers and high school for about 20 kilometers. There is no residential school nearby. The tribal children are facing a lot of problem. Many of them are not seen how the school is. Here you can see, these are the children. We are not even know what is the school and how the school is functioning. Very few of them are going and the dropout rate is very high. Here in this village, I observed only 25% of the students, around 20 students, children only going for the school, which is at a distance of 4 kilometers. And many of them are not going to the school, which you can see here among them, who is having the uniform, they are going this for the school. The rest of them are not going to the school.
drop out, this boy is drop out from the school to take care of her younger sister, and there is no food for them, and they had to go for the forest for the collection pair.
जाए
नहीं ना
इसको जाता है नहीं जाता है
so he is not going for the school and he's taking care of the himself.
Sir, I wanted to know what kind of horticulture we can able to develop in the plain areas on the hills with for Birjia and Ashur and Korwa. That is what which we wanted to know.
In everywhere you have find a lot of vacant land, mostly that is called rented upland. And a lot of scope in this pocket we have to develop. First of all, you should know that government, Jharkhand government already implemented the NHM project, yes, in which the mango plantation is recommended by the NHM. And as you ask me, which type of fruit crop in this area is suited for best economic profitability, in this way I will definitely ask to you or anyone, the jackfruit, amla, mango, even lychee, papaya is the most important. One of the very important food that is called naspati. Naspati is already grown in a huge pocket of the Netrahatipam, and farmer earn very good. In spite of the fruit crop, here you will find in fact maize, the potentiality of the maize cultivation.
Populations are living in the inaccessible areas of Vindhya Hills. The major problems which they are facing is the water problem. Here, the basic infrastructure they are not having. The water is one of the major problems which they are facing. That is water they had to go nearly 4 kilometers. I think you have seen the previous clipping. They are bringing the water from 4 kilometers for their consumption. So it is very difficult for these people to bring the water. That is one of the important one, first one which you have to provide in the basic infrastructure facility, water facility for drinking. Here you can see, the second one is the health problem. Most of the men and women, you can see, all are malnourished. You can see here, all are malnourished. She is anemic, she is having the kid, she is very weak, and also she is also very weak. See, all the pregnant and lactating mothers, which you can observe here, all are very weak. They doesn't have any nutritional support food in this village. And you can see here, one of the old women is suffering with the eyes problem. Here you can see, she is having the eyes problem. She was not able to see, the proper vision problem is there. And also this old man, here you can see the eyes problem. Visibility has slowly it is going. So not only the eyes problem, they have many problems which is affecting the gastric problems, different type of health problems they are facing. Here you can see the children, they are all malnourished. You see the children, they doesn't have proper food, one meal also they are not able to take. Here you can see the kids which are suffering with the malnourishment. So the basic necessary is to give them the malnourishment to solve the malnourishment, good food for them. At least once in a day they have to be provided. The next basic infrastructure facility is the road. There is no road to this village. One has to walk nearly 6 hours to reach the village. That is the inaccessible areas. You can see here, she is bringing the water. She is bringing the water from nearly 3 to 4 kilometers distance. What is the river name? Wo naam kya hai? Wo pani lekar aata hai na, uska naam kya hai?
Lal Matia,
she is bringing the water. This is the condition of these people.
Due to the scarcity of water, they cannot take bath properly.
Yeah. Most of them are because of non-availability water resource nearby, they won't take bath also. Many of them are weeks together, they are not taking the bath. That is also one of the important ones. As though there are some people are going, children are going for school, there is no bath for them. That is very important one. And another one is which you are observing here, health facilities. If anybody gets a health problem, they have to go nearly 15 kilometers by walk only to get the treatment. And most of the deliveries will be conducted in the village itself with the traditional dye. There is no medical facilities or anybody will be coming to this village. No Anganwadi worker, no health worker is coming to this village. That is the pathetic condition these are in these inaccessible Vindhya Hills. Then another one important one which I wanted to hear, they are facing the socio-economic conditions, socio-economic problems. They are still living in the forest, depending on the minor forest produce, different types of roots, tubers, they are consuming green leaves and fruits they are depending. So there is no proper agriculture for them, as though they have given land for each family. There is no agriculture facility provided to them. See, here we can see they have lands, but there is no provision for them to do the agriculture. According to our observations, they should be given horticulture, growing of more number of different kind of fruits and vegetables. See, here the land is rich, fertile land for the growing of the fruits. Different kind of fruits, oranges, jackfruits, bananas, all these horticulture can be developed so that the people can able to sell in the nearby market. That is very important. Another important one, the economy is there doesn't have any economic organization. Still they are depending on the barter system to sell their forest produce. They are collecting the roots and tubers and other things. They are selling it to the middlemen, not direct to the forest. So there is a need for them to have a cooperative society or Girijan society which they can able to purchase their produce. So some of the major problems which they are facing are the water, health, economic, or the major conditions which they are facing. So I request the policy makers or the decision makers or the national builders, the politicians and administration to come into this, to look into these aspects of the problems and issues to save this population. Otherwise, this Asur population is going to extinct from the planet. This is a unique population. First, these are the people who invented the iron because they are living on the land of the bauxite and the hematite which are available here in this one. These people first melted the iron and given to us civilization. The civilization present today, iron using means because of these people only. So we should not lose these people. We have to conserve, we have to save this population who have given us the civilization of iron. So this Asur population is very important for us for cultural preservation, and also ecologically we have to conserve these people. So I request the nation and the people of India to save these aborigines. At the end, I will thank all my people who supported me in documenting the film, not only the tribals of these leaders and the women and all these village elders and my friend Jha, who brought me here from Ranchi and has made the arrangement to see is it here, and also research scholars which are here, come here. And Vikas Samiti has helped me to bring me here. I thank one and all the people here and my friends for helping me to document this ethnic vision.
The present research documentary film may fulfill the desires of many scholars to know about the Birjia ethnography all over the world. I am dedicating this film to my parents, Padma and Krishna, and also to the people of India. Thank you very much. Please have a vision and write to me about your impressions, all my documentary ethnographic films. Thank you very much.